Dweebcast.
Hey Indie Gamers, I'm Andy Riesmeyer, this is Dweebcast. Here's something cool for you. Okay, so have you seen this game yet? It's called Long Dark. It's a post-apocalyptic survival game set in the Northern Territories in Canada. It's unbelievable, super exciting. Right now, joining me is the creative director from Hinterland Studios, Raphael Van Lierop. How you doing, Raphael?
I'm great, how are you doing?
Very well, thank you. And congratulations, you guys just funded your Kickstarter. Got 200, and I looked like a couple minutes ago, $240,000. You were looking for 200. How does that feel?
Feels great. You know, the team's really stoked about it. We're really, really excited about how everyone's responded to the concept. You know, we've had a really big last week. I think we've raised over 60,000 just in the last sort of 4 or 5 days.
Were you kind of nervous coming up to it? Like, oh my God, are we going to make it?
I mean, it was a little hairy for a while. I think every Kickstarter, like, or a lot of them anyways, follow this sort of curve where they have a big burst at the beginning and then things kind of go into a bit of a quiet phase. And then since then, we've been able to announce, you know, Jennifer Hale's involvement and David Hayter's involvement on top of Mark Meer and Elias Tofexis. We haven't really got into a lot of detail about storytelling or the characters in the world that we're building beyond what we've given in updates in our Kickstarter.
Sure.
And so we're probably not going to be talking too much about those right now. But certainly in the next coming months, we'll be revealing more about the characters that each of those actors is playing and kind of how it fits into the bigger story.
I was looking at some of your incentives, and there's one that's like, for $1,200, you can have dinner with Mark Meer, but if you pledge more than that, you can't have dinner with him anymore. What's that? What is that about? Or am I just reading that wrong?
It's just like a specific tier, basically, that's just for someone who maybe doesn't want to have the rewards that come beyond that and have the shipping costs and all that kind of stuff, but really, really wants to have dinner with Mark Meer. And that was a reward that we threw in there really early on when we first announced Mark Meer's involvement, and we just thought it would be fun. You know, so, yeah, I mean, that's pretty much all. The only reason why it's set up that way.
So let's talk about the game if you haven't seen it already, which is ridiculous. Like, come on, take a look at it. What are some of the challenges that you guys, you know, face when trying to create a game that's so absolutely different?
You know, we've always approached it from a little bit more of the standpoint of, you know, how can we make a very exploration-focused game that has a little bit more of a maybe literary, artistic feel to it? That theme exists throughout all the things that we've discussed, whether it's the way the art style has evolved or the storytelling or the talent that we've brought on board or what we're doing with the simulation gameplay or any of those things. It's always been about, you know, trying to deliver something that feels true to our creative values and the fact that we just are fiercely independent and we just kind of want to do things our own way.
And I think that shows as far as, like, you know, the gameplay that we saw and all the stills that we've seen. They're just totally unique and they have this, like, very, I don't know, it kind of reminded me, it gave me sort of like nostalgia for the way I think I used to feel about video games when I was a kid.
I think that it's interesting that you bring that up, and that's very intentional on our part. Like, we want to create a feeling, you know, of like creating a world that people want to kind of lose themselves into and introduce a feeling of sort of the magic of the environment. You know, and this is why we have such a beautiful art style. This is why we have things like the Aurora being such kind of a strong visual characteristic for us. We set out from the very beginning to create a style that was going to be very iconic, that could stand on its own, and that immediately as soon as you look at the game, you know that it's the Long Dark.
Obviously in the gameplay demo we saw the survival sort of back and forth with the wolf and the fire.
Where did he come
from? Is it always sort of a survival thing, or do you have the choice then to maybe like fight the wolf as opposed to, you know, set a fire and have it go away?
Yeah, I mean, the game is not very combat focused, although there is combat in it. It's very much about exploration and survival, but it's certainly not an action game, and it's not about fighting. And even with something like a wolf or you know, a bear or some other element of wildlife, you wouldn't take that on without, you know, being very, very sure that you could win, and you would really want to avoid it as much as you can because, you know, this isn't a game where you have, like, auto-regenerating health and, you know, 10 seconds after encounter you're going to be fine. This is a game where, you know, if you end up getting, you know, wounded and it gets infected, you know, you might die, you know, 2 weeks later because of that mistake. And so, you know, this is a lot more about cautious survival and learning to read the environment and being careful in how you approach things and using your intelligence as a player to read the environment, listen to what it's telling you, and make good decisions about how you're going to survive.
Very exciting. Raphael, thank you so much for talking with us. If we want to find out more about The Long Dark, how do we do it?
Well, for the next, you know, 19 hours or so, you can check the Kickstarter page. We also have a microsite for the game that we've just launched yesterday that also allows for PayPal pledges. That's at intothelongdark.com. So, you know, we're really thrilled to be talking with you guys about the game, and we hope that some of your audience, you know, is interested in what we have to say and will come out and check out the community and be part of it.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Talk to you later.
Thank you. Take care.
Do you making the Twitters? Follow the Dweebcasts at Dweebcast.
I got breaking news about Dweeb stuff and videos and pictures. Do it.